Sometimes when using Xactimate, you may find that you can't find exactly the item you need in the price list. I'm going to show you how to do that as well as add a custom item. For every category in an Xactware price list, there are two items that are designed to be used as custom items. They are the bid item and miscellaneous item. While these two items are similar, they are slightly different. The bid item is most frequently used when you receive a priced bid from a third party, like a custom handrail. The miscellaneous item is often used when you are buying the materials and doing the work yourself. Both items function in similar ways in your estimate. Before we add the item, it's important to choose the correct category. Normally, the best category to choose is the trade that would normally do the work. In this example, we'll add a bid item for custom cabinets to be built and installed by a third party, and a miscellaneous item for specialty carpet. We'll start with the bid item for the cabinets. To add a bid item, first enter the proper category code in the quick entry pad in estimate items. For our cabinets, we'll use the CAB category code. The selector code for a bid item is BIDITM. Once I have selected the category and selector codes, I'll add a custom description by replacing the text in the description field. I enter the total price by clicking on the price and entering the total in the text field on the unit price tab to the right. A miscellaneous item is similar. In this case, I found the matching carpet pattern for the rest of the home and know the unit price per square yard for materials for this specialized carpet. The category code for the carpet is FCC, and because I have an exact price per square yard, I'll want a custom item. I'm going to use MISC as the selector code. I'll enter my custom description and go to edit the price. Because I'm going to be paying for the materials per square yard, I'm going to change the unit of measure to match. Instead of just writing out a total price, I'm going to click the I button to provide more information. In this window, I can break the total cost into its components. Here, I can enter the price per unit for the materials and the price per unit for labor. You can modify the price of a bid item like this as well. And that's it. You know how to add bid items and miscellaneous items to your estimate.